Hoe is het Afrikaans acronym voor Orion Observation Group, or the Orion Observation Group? Hoe is an informal astronomy club in existence for 15 years already, operating in the Boland area near Cape Town, South Africa. We do a lot of public outreach, showing the public through our telescopes, mainly from the Afrikaans Language Monument near Paarl. Hoog's so-called telescope jockeys recently went to a dark site for a bit of bonding, cross-pollination and some serious stargazing amongst ourselves. One of our members, Mike Lippen, identified a possible site near Ribicus Steel. Mike and Carol Botha beforehand went out to a field on the well-known Delico farm to ensure it is dark enough. Apart from some distant lights beyond the local horizon, it was a perfect setting. After topping up for some provisions of delicious Delico biltong and droewors for the night, some 20-odd Oog members, including a few guests, amongst them the owners of the farm, the Treaters, with perfect weather, were ready for an exciting night under the stars. Here are some quotes from Carol's observing report from her website in the link below. We kicked off by observing Valikosa's drone as it went high in the sky into Canis Major. Yes, Sirius just appeared. At the same time, Venus became brighter over Ribicus Steel, putting up a spectacular show. As it grew darker, there was a myriad of objects to choose from. I started off with Orion, as it would be the first to set in the west. The belt stars Alnitak, Alnilam and Mintaka are always a welcoming sight. From them, orientation to a new location is quite easy. The stars Betelgeuse and Rigel, the Orion Nebula, and from there to Canis Major, the Big Dog, and its brightest star Sirius, were all familiar constellations that we meet up regularly during our summer outreach events at the Taal Monument in Paarl. Later on at some stage, Willie commanded all laser pointers to be directed at a different star in Canis Major. Serena will notice her laser pointer on Sirius. The stars of the Southern Cross lured me into the southern part of the sky. I always checked to see whether the jewel box was still as beautiful as ever, and it was. Next up, double star Icarus, Alpha Crucis, the Coalsack or the Dark Nebula, and one of the big five of the African sky was clearly visible, and Johan Leroux took some awful photos with his cell phone. The half-man, half-horse Centaurus is sort of jumping over Crux. The huge globular cluster Omega Centauri, a big five, riding on its back was a popular target. The constellation of Carina is laden with deep sky gems. Eta Carina, bright nebula and a big five object. NGC 3532, an open cluster called Wishing Well Cluster or Football Cluster. The Southern Pleiades, another big five. And NGC 2516, an open cluster, sometimes called the Southern Beehive. Willie mentioned the Southern Ring Nebula. I know this planet in nebula as the 8th Birth Nebula and found the catalog designation NGC 3132. Thanks to the spot-on searching and abilities of the Mead, Willie tracked it down in the constellation of Vela in no time. We could actually see the central star. I spotted another planetary nebula in SS Top 100 list, the Ghost of Jupiter in Hydra. Again, Willie guided his scope and a beautiful bluish disk appeared, like Jupiter shrouded in mist. This was so cool to observe as the real Jupiter was showing off its bands and moons to the east. Our list of ops for the evening was growing, M65, M66 in Leo, two galaxies showing in the same telescope field of view. To see the third of the Leo triplet, we would have needed a wider field of view. Just seeing the upside-down Leo sequel was awesome. I wanted to see the last object of the big five of the African skies before I left the Milky Way Sagittarius region. Jan Visser pointed out the teapot asterism riding in the east, and even though the center of our Milky Way was low on the horizon and in considerable sky glow, the Milky Way in that region was prominent, but light pollution from a nearby village made imaging difficult. Some folks were leaving. Willie was experimenting with time-lapse photography and had even more tricks up his sleeve. Mars was quite high above the horizon, and as I was saying final goodbyes, the Northern Crown Corona Borealis caught my eye, and I wished that I still had the stamina of years ago when I could go from dusk to dawn. Thanks to Mike Lippen for organizing this event, Jan Visser and Hansie Schroeder for driving to Rebecca Steele with me, and all my astronomy friends, and especially Willie and his mate, for another incredible stargazing adventure.